Hello, Patrick Walchuk here. We're filming this at the end of September 2024, and what we wanted to do is make you aware of zoning bylaw changes that are proposed, and if they are enacted, they will become law in Ottawa somewhere around the third or maybe the fourth quarter of 2025. So let's take a look at them because they are once in a generation type of thing. I've been doing this for 30 years and I've not seen significant bylaw changes like this before. So zoning, the way it's laid out now, you may or may not be familiar, but neighborhoods are divided up into, for example, R1, R2, R3 zones. So just on the surface, an R1 zone basically means that a single family detached house goes there, and that's all that can go on that lot. Now, there are changes that can happen to it. For example, in any zone in the city, you can put a basement apartment in that house, and that's called an SDU. And you can do maybe a couple of other things, but basically, when you drive down the street, you're going to see single-family homes in R1 lots. R2 is two houses, for example, side by side, semi-detached properties, that kind of thing. And you will have these different R1 and R2, maybe even on the same block. So all of that information, the way that the city's been regulated in terms of the density throughout every neighborhood, is being thrown out the window, and they're going to change it by looking at a geographic area and determining how many units per hectare can go in a given area. So rather than being called R1, R2, it's going to be now called N1, N2, N3, and the N stands for neighborhood. N1 has a lower density, that's a lower number of units per hectare. And this is from the city's website, they're giving us some methods to calculate the number of dwelling units per hectare. So we'll just move on from this. And remember I mentioned the N1, N2 thing. So what they're saying is that in a neighborhood that's really low density, you're allowed to have 60 units per hectare. In an area where they want more density, and those will be areas, for example, around major arterial roads, like, I don't know, Baseline Avenue, Woodruff Avenue, that kind of thing. They want more density because there's more transit there. So that neighborhood would have 250 units per hectare. Now, if we move on to the next slide, just because there's a certain number of units permitted per hectare, and that will determine the number of units that can go on a given lot, doesn't mean, for example, if it says you can put up a 20-unit building on this lot, well, maybe you can, but maybe you can't. And when I say you can't, that will be subject to contingencies, for example, like the height of the building. You can't build an unlimited height to a property, and setbacks. So there's going to be a minimum lot width, and then it'll be different subzones A, B, C, and D, and all that good stuff. And it'll also be subject to setbacks. So you got a building on a lot, the building has to be a certain distance away from the lot line to the front yard, a certain distance away from the lot line to the backyard. So it just can't be the maximum size that you can stick on the lot, yes, but subject to these other contingencies, if you will. So let's move on to the next slide, and I want to show you an exact example of a lot and what you could put on it. So if we look at an R1 zone and we assume there's a single family house, two-story, three-bedroom house, Alta Vista, St. Clair Gardens, somewhere in Orleans, whatever, and that's changing to N2, which is very, very common, and a lot of these places are actually changing to N3. So in our example, R1 to N2, okay? So 1 hectare equals 107,639 square feet. So let's take a lot of 75 feet by 100, just for round numbers, right? Obviously that's 7,500 square feet in this example lot. So the lot of 7,500 square feet divided by the number of feet in the hectare, 107,000, gives us a number of 0.069. Now, N2 density, as you saw on the previous slide, that allowed for 150 units per hectare. So N2, 150 units per hectare. So on this lot, what it's saying is that you can build 150 units times the number we crunched out here. You can put up 10 units on this lot. So previously, where there'd been one single family home, two stories, three bedrooms, you can now put up a 10-unit apartment building. Now, maybe it can't be 10 units. Again, maybe it would exceed the height restriction. Maybe it would exceed being too close to the lot line on one side or the backyard, that kind of thing. But, you know, quite likely you can put up a 4, 5, 6-unit building that you couldn't do before. So this is the type of change that is coming. It's significant. I would invite you to go to the City of Ottawa website and learn more about it. And you can even type in your address and it shows you what your current zoning is and what the new zoning will be this time next year. Hope you enjoyed this. Thank you for watching.